Benidorm is a quiet, tranquil fishing village tucked away on the Costa Blanca on the east coast of Spain. Well, it was in the 1960s, it ain't anymore. Today, well over a million of us head here every year for our summer holes, and many decide to stick around, dodging the grey and cold of the UK for a new life in the sun.
Hola!
But what does it take to be a Benidorm budget expat?
It's cheaper to wash a car in wine than it is in bottled water over here.
From work to love and scrimping to living, this is the guide on how to be a bargain-loving Brit in the sun. Coming up, the lowdown on low-cost living.
Three-course meal, bottle of wine, half a lager for £4.50. How bad's that?
Cheapest chips away days to where the big boys play.
Is that Abramovich? Is that one? Mr. Moneybags, who owns Chelsea. That's his boat there.
And the bargain boozer with the cheapest drinks in town.
A euro a pint? It's expensive.
Balmy summer sun and balmy low prices have enticed more than 30,000 Brits to bin Britain and bunk down in Benidorm permanently, hoping for a cut-price life in the sun.
Gosh, it's a hot day, isn't it? Phew, it's all right for them holidaymakers sitting doing nothing.
Priority number one when you've arrived, get a roof over your head, and the accommodation of choice for any bargain-loving Brit is the caravan.
You're not buying a caravan, you're buying a dream.
If you want to start a new life in Benidorm, but you don't have many pennies in the purse, then a caravan could be a perfect sunshine starter home.
You can hold the shower and you can shower yourself down. Then you just put that back in there and it becomes a sink again.
As you can see, it's only a small kitchen, but that's all you need.
Singer Eddie Robinson's come to Benidorm hoping to crack it as a performer. But with only enough money to last him a month, a campsite has provided the perfect Costa Blanca crash pad.
Spent a couple of days here and I ended up buying a caravan for €500. Key for the caravan, very small one for a very big dream. I've never had a caravan before, so it's all a bit of an adventure.
There are 10 campsites in town and lots of happy campers.
Living on a campsite, you'll meet loads of different people, loads of different characters. Girls. Everyone knows everyone else and you just all mix in together.
When you found your caravan, you also need to shell out for your pitch. At Camping Benidorm, Essex lad Dean lives and works at the site.
Welcome to Camping Benidorm, the friendliest campsite in Benidorm.
Your wages is not the best, but it's cheaper living. Plus, you've got the sun. You ain't got to pay for that. It costs nothing.
Dean is proud of his budget bachelor pad.
I'll pay about £310 and then electric, which starts about €30. That's cheap living. It is a glorified tent, it is all tent-like, but it's how you make home, you know what I mean? Getting in the bedroom here, oh, this caravan's seen some action. If the van's rocking, don't come knocking, you know what I mean?
Moving on. Another couple very comfortable with caravan life are Jill and Maria Ryan, who moved to Benidorm 3 years ago after selling their pub in Wigan. Their top tip for new arrivals? Manage your expectations, count your blessings and stay positive.
Come along to our little humble abode. This is the original eBay caravan, £800. Now, you see, I would call this a tent with clothes.
And I call it the walk-in wardrobe.
It's a very simple life, but we simply love it.
Yeah, we do.
For me, right here, right now, this is living a dream.
But when the Benidorm dream turns sour, caravans are often ditched at a moment's notice, as parking boss John Anderson sees all too often.
Well, the smell hits you straight away.
Damn me.
Oh, God. I think something died in here. You know, I'm a bit of a tramp, but I do actually go to the toilet instead of bottles down the back there. Would you want to sleep in there? Would it? It's like the Mary Celeste could have just gone and left everything. This caravan is basically scrap. People come over here and they think it's they're buying their dreams, but this is a prime example of when it's gone wrong.
The best way of keeping the Spanish dream alive is to try and live cheaply until you find your feet.
Come out here, and if you've got a little bit of money and not a fortune, life's just a breeze.
You could live a millionaire's lifestyle with nothing, really, you know what I mean?
Our expats have lots of clever cost-cutting ideas. Here are some of them. First up, free stuff. Want free water? Take a trip to the hills. Scouse singer Eddie fills up his fridge for free.
Fresh spring mountain water. I mean, it probably costs couple of euros and petrol. But if you take five bottles with you and you get like 40 litres of it, I don't know how much 40 litres it cost in the shops.
Just make sure you avoid the toll roads.
Oh no, that kind of defeats the purpose, doesn't it?
Brush up on your Spanish for when you get lost.
Hola, looking for the water spring. Aqua, I think it's up here.
But just don't expect a great view.
I was expecting it, you know, to be kind of on the mountain with a stream of water coming down over the rocks, but just a little pipe coming out the wall.
Well, it is free, sort of.
We'll have to be wary of that toll road next time we come up here.
If it's an alcoholic tipple you're after, there's always happy hour, which at Camping Villamar kicks off at 5 p.m. every day.
The rats, as I call them, start coming in. Some of them will wait outside at 5-2, pretend they're talking to somebody on a mobile phone, and then they enter the building smack on 5 o'clock.
If I leave my caravan at 2 minutes to five, I'm here at 5 o'clock on the dot.
They're all living on a budget, that's what it is.
It's €1 a pint. I mean, where can you get a pint for a euro?
A euro a pint? It's expensive. Relating to exchange rates at the moment, it's probably working out at about 75 pence a pint.
The beer might be just 40 cents cheaper in happy hour, but as the saying goes, when you watch the pennies, the pounds look after themselves. And it also helps to be good at maths. That way you can work out the savings, making the beer taste even better.
So you're 40 cents and there's two of us, that's 80 cents, and we have maybe half a dozen bottles, so that's 480. So use that, that's 30, €35, so that's €1,750 a year.
Food can offer up tasty savings too. Drag artist Dusty Crack and his partner David have some awful ideas when it comes to cheap dinners.
This is lamb's head. This is lovely to do in a stew. Lovely flavour.
Well, it's about 6 years we've just spent all together.
Yes.
And we can probably get about between 4 and 5 days worth of meals out of those.
Happy days.
That's the cheap eats in sorted, but there are cheap eats out too.
The cheapest English breakfast is €3 for a full English breakfast and a pint.
Going to have a Chinese, 3-course meal, bottle of wine, half a lager for £4.50. How bad's that? You couldn't do that in England, could you?
And bar owner Tad has a simple approach to saving a few quid. Just ask to pay less.
Me being a little bit cheeky, I'm always in to see manager for a bit of discount. Discount's 16%. That's what you've got to do when you're in this business. Proud to be a Yorkshireman, and I always get it cheaper. Always.
When you've made a move to the Costas, it's time to start earning a crust.
Whoa!
And the expat motto is...
I work hard. I work hard and I play hard.
And anything you do in Spain, if you work hard, you're going to make money.
Forget Silicon Valley. This is the land of the British entrepreneur. When it comes to taking a gamble and rolling the dice, few can equal Yorkshire lass Vicky Caton. She came to Benidorm on a whim 11 years ago and bought Hepburn's Hair Salon 1 year later, also completely on a whim.
I didn't know anything whatsoever about hairdressing. I just did it in a moment's madness, maybe. It was crazy, really. Absolutely ridiculous.
Having one successful business is usually enough for most here, but that's not the case with human energy ball Vicky. She's expanding the brand and moving from haircuts to hot tubs with a 5-year lease on a luxury spa.
I went from not knowing it existed to buying it in 10 days. A bit crazy.
3 months after opening, has Vicky's splurge on the spa paid off?
I had a big panic attack about 2 nights before we were due to open and worried, was it actually going to work? But it's picked up much quicker than I expected, so I'm feeling good. Very tired, but very happy.
Vicky's now bought 2 businesses on a whim, so are there any plans for a third?
You never say never, but I don't actually have any plans to do anything else. I plan to retire nicely from this in a couple of years' time. Well, 5, 10, 20. Sometime.
Spotting a gap in the market and taking a punt can be a recipe for success, but often with a side order of stress. Curry House boss Raj Kausar has taken on a huge new site which he plans to turn into an Italian restaurant. But halfway through the summer, it's still a building site and Raj is fretting.
I'd already started paying the rents here. Every day I'm losing money. We're already in the middle of the summer. Once the summer is gone, it's gone. So every day is really important.
By hook or by crook, the restaurant is ready for opening day. Well, almost. And the customers pile in for pizza and pasta. 3 months on, Raj is confident he'll get a decent return on his investment.
This place had costed me over 200,000 euros. It's gonna take time to recover all this money, but this place is definitely gonna pay me back in future. I'm really looking forward to next year. It's gonna be a big year, big, big year.
To be an innovator like Raj, you must always be poised to jump on new trends and opportunities.
I never thought of opening a Chinese restaurant, for example. But you never know. Who knows future? Never say never, as you said.
Welsh-born Karen Robinson has seen a gap in the market that she wants to fill, quite literally. She runs a pie and pasty store that's proving a big hit with the Brits.
I think it works in Benidorm because it's home from home.
It's €5 then, please.
We're known as Benidorm's answer to Greggs.
Another business style is the all-hands-on-deck approach, as adopted by the Coburn family. They've just sold their townhouse in Essex and bought the popular Showboat Cabaret Bar to embark on a real Benidorm adventure.
We are nervous. We are taking on a lot, we know that, but it's something we've always wanted.
Opening night gets a big turnout.
It's going really well. We're now packed out in the Cabaret Bar. I'm smiling, I'm happy.
Their first summer season is over, so how's it been for the Coburns?
Yeah, I've got to say, it has been tougher than I think we all expected. It's a big venue to get to grips with. I think you learn as you go along. But from a business point of view, I couldn't be happier. We're doing really well.
Karen's been impressed with Mick's aptitude for the pub game.
At first, he'd come home and he had a few nights where he was, like, pulling his hair out, didn't know if he could do it, but now he just seems to have really settled in. Him and the girls have just... They've worked together as a team. I've been really proud of them.
And running a bar has made Mick much less of a man.
Yeah, I reckon I must have done about 3.5-4 stone in weight. Yeah, I feel a lot better for it and, yeah, I feel a bit trimmer for it. It's not down to exercise. It's more down to running around and, yeah, you're just never ending. You're just always on the go.
He has lost a hell of a lot of weight. And he won't like me saying it, but because of his age, he won't do him no harm losing that bit of weight. So, yeah.
The Coburn family are definitely sticking with Spain.
We plan to stay here for, like, evermore. We've got no intentions of going back to the UK. Like, we want to make it work out here. And us as a family, I think we're stronger than ever because we all want to fight and strive to make the Showboat a bigger, better business and to be a successful business in Benidorm.
Mick and Karen aren't the only married couple to move to Benidorm. Lots of people up sticks to come here and live the dream with their life partners.
We've been married now 61 years.
Come on, say what you always say.
If I'd have done a couple of murders, I'd have been free now.
Manchester lad Wayne Wright recently sold the Showboat to Mick and Karen so he could spend more time with his partner, Des.
Comes a time in your life where you think there is more to life than working.
Selling the business has definitely improved the couple's relationship.
More relaxed.
I'm just too relaxed now, aren't I? Yeah. I don't know how I ever got time to do all them hours. It's kind of good because I've got loads of time to catch up with friends and family and, you know, phone calls and emails. I've never, ever in my life had so much time to myself and I just love it.
And Wayne's got a new project that's keeping him busy.
What Des doesn't know is I'm going to ask him to marry me next week. I've been emailing wedding venues and I've wrote guest lists and everything, and he has no idea whatsoever yet. You know, we've worked together, we're buying our first house together, we've already had puppies, doing it the wrong way around, you see, we had the babies first.
You don't have to move here with a partner. There's a single scene too. But if you want to meet someone, you have to be proactive about it. Like estate agent Amanda Penalva. She's always on the go.
Let me do a quick look.
Please yeah. Do.
They've walked in here and it's taken their breath away. So I'm thinking we could have a sale here.
But when it comes to her love life, offers are a bit thin on the ground.
I want to find love. But it's definitely a challenge because most people don't come to Benidorm to find love. If you were looking for a serious relationship, you wouldn't get on the coach and go to Scarborough. People are here for a good time. There is the odd person that wouldn't mind finding love, but it's like finding a thimble in a haystack.
almost as hard as finding a needle, Amanda. She turns to her laptop in an effort to find love.
I've had an interesting time on online dating. I've had some complete wazzocks that I've come across. I've had guys that have been sending me their nether regions while I'm doing the ironing, which maybe isn't the most attractive thing in the world.
But she's clicked with a digital Don Juan.
His name's Luis. Looks very attractive in the photos, and I'm really excited, but a little bit flattery for that first meet.
It's time for Amanda to meet her keyboard Casanova, and she's hoping passion will be on the menu.
I'm hoping for a first kiss today, maybe two.
You look amazing. Thank How you me. Doing?
Very good, are you?
Yeah.
Amanda goes for a pretty standard opening line.
So have you been to Benidorm before?
And then she goes off-piste.
Have you ever had Yorkshire puddings?
The laptop lovebirds took into a carvery.
Traditionally on a Sunday, a British person will have this for their lunch. Mm-hmm.
I tell you the truth, I haven't my print of this, but it's really, really good.
Before Amanda gets the dessert she was hoping for. So 3 months later, has Amanda found love with Luis?
I feel like I've just come off of Greece, really. It was summer loving, but now real life's caught up. Jose Luis is a tour guide, and he goes away for long periods of time. I can't make him Luis, the postman that's going to come home to me every night at 5 o'clock. So if he's going to be away for 2 or 3 months at a time, that's not much of a relationship, really.
Poor Amanda. Hope she hasn't forgotten her login details for those dating sites.
I 100% think there's a Mr. Right out there. I just got to find him. I've definitely not given up on love, so I'm going to be out there in the future.
Back at Wayne and Des's villa, it's the day of the surprise proposal.
Of course, I've been right busy plotting this wedding, and he's still not got a clue, you know. It's like, I've booked the venue and everything.
Wayne's previously been married, but Des has never walked down the aisle before.
Stayed on my own for 5 years before I met Des. And then I met him outside a bar. He was asking me, he said, "Excuse me, mate, do you know where Lover's Pub is?" And we get to talking, and that's it, 4 years ago. What if he says no? He'll be getting me nervous now. A bit too late for that, innit?
As the evening arrives, it's time to get ready. But there's a snag, or rather a snap.
Oh, no. That's bloody typical, that, innit, when you're in a rush to play a match.
When it comes to romance, Wayne's not exactly a natural.
I think our first date when I came over here to Spain was to the crematorium. He says, "Get dressed up, I'm taking you out." We went to a funeral.
Time to go.
At a posh restaurant in town, the stage is set. But at the critical moment, suddenly Wayne starts to lose it.
I'm crying now. I've just bottled it now.
Flowers arrive, which is a welcome distraction.
Do you like them? I got them from the crematorium. When I was first day at the crematorium, so I'll go there and rob some flowers, right? I thought it'd be quite apt on the day. I'm going to say, "Will you marry me?"
Yeah, of course.
Good, because I've already booked it. To us,
the future.
Stop it now. Right, come on, wife. You got dogs to walk.
The wedding will take place back in the UK in a few weeks' time, but there's no time like the present for a bit of practice.
Here comes the bride. Now you have to walk like that.
Wayne's one of the best-known performers in Benidorm, but there's lots of competition. Entertainers are 10 a penny in the town, and keeping your act fresh is the key. But keeping up with the times can come at a price.
These ones I got for doing Amy Winehouse. I just got the number in and she bloody died on me, didn't she? I thought, how inconsiderate's that? I thought, oh, thanks, Amy. Bloody Michael Jackson did the same. And Whitney.
A talent for entertainment can be a great way to bring in the bucks in Benidorm, but it's often more slog and sweat than glitz and glamour. A typical gig earns about €60, so singers like Jill Ryan maximise their income by dashing around the town, performing at 2 or 3 venues a night.
It's all go, 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 see you in a bit. You quite often see other artists rushing between gigs. It's mental because you're running down the street to your next gig and you're just like, keep going.
Female impersonator Dusty Crack has certainly cracked it when it comes to saving the pennies. He's on first-name terms with the second-hand shops.
The cheaper you can design your outfits, the more money stays in your pocket. For €5, that's a bargain.
Another dusty tip, recycle wigs using spray paint.
Just buying 4 cans at £1.50 is a lot cheaper than going out and buying a 70, €80 wig.
Got a gig to get to? A chauffeur-driven limo bargain Brit style. That's the number 10 bus to Benidorm Central. Luxury dressing room? Forget it.
This is my little chamber where I get changed.
Be prepared to drum up your own business.
It only takes one stag group or hen party to come round the corner and the place is full.
And when the show does go on, don't expect a big payout for your performance.
All that just for €50. But it's a job and it pays the bills. What more could you ask for? Apart from a very large brandy.
Before you get your name in lights, you need to get your foot in the door. And that means pounding the pavements. But don't expect to hit the big time straight away, as Scouse singer Eddie Robinson discovers.
Now, I've no openings for the cabaret at the moment. For July, August, September, we've got our acts sorted.
However, be prepared to grab every opportunity, even if it takes you by surprise.
Can you sing for us now?
Can I sing for you now?
Do you want karaoke?
What, right now?
Right now. Just down the road.
OK.
I see.
Why not?
Say what you got.
OK. Slightly odd. I've never been asked to do an impromptu karaoke performance before, but, you know, whatever it takes.
The trial by karaoke ends with a thumbs up.
Thank you very much.
And more importantly, a booking.
Tell you what I've got this week.
Yeah.
Sunday.
Cheers, Jackie. Thanks a lot, love.
Thank you, darling.
But chasing a dream doesn't always have a happy ending. 58-year-old magician Barry Harvey has spent £900 to rent a room for 2 months in his quest for success.
This is it. It's not massive, but I'm on my own, so I don't need a massive space. It's a big risk moving out here. I mean, I'm 58 now. I'm stepping way out of my comfort zone here. So, quite literally, anything could happen in the next few weeks.
Like Eddie, Barry's put himself in the shop window.
It's going to be a red rose, isn't it?
Yeah. It's an unpaid audition, really. But as I'm totally unknown out here, I'm going to have to do a few of these to just kind of get my foot in the door.
Well, I found the 4 aces. That's a good trick.
Very good.
But unfortunately, Barry can't magic up any work offers, and he's forced into a disappearing act.
The initial plan was to give it 2 months, but things haven't worked out as well as I wanted. I've come to the end of the budget.
Barry dishes up another lesson for anyone with a dream of making it in Benidorm. Be persistent.
I've taken the decision to go back to England temporarily, and I stress it is temporarily. I have every intention of coming back out here.
Generally in life, I'm an optimist, and I'm gonna keep plugging away.
I'll be back.
Welcome back to our guide on how to be a bargain-loving Brit in the sun. So what should you expect when you get to the Costa Blanca? And do you need to bring a phrase book when you come? Some expats have a very Rule Britannia ethos about life overseas. Take bar owner Tad, for example. He's been in Benny for more than 20 years, but still prefers A-up to hola.
I don't speak Spanish at all. You don't need to in Benidorm. Benidorm's England.
I'd like to learn Spanish, but it's actually sitting and learning it that I couldn't be bothered with.
One cerveza, one beer, vino, blanco, white wine. So I've got the basics.
I can say Sprite in Spanish, which is just basically the same, but with a Spanish accent. And I can say un momento.
Si cerveza, por favor.
Café con leche. No, that's not Spanish, though, is it? Is that Spanish? Oh, I could say that as well.
That's Spanish.
No, that was Italian.
I was going to go do Spanish lessons, but there's no point because everybody speaks English.
Donde es el lavabo? That means where is the sink?
You always need to know where a sink is.
Because everybody speaks English, we just don't have to bother.
But the Spanish do appreciate it when you make a bit of an effort. Entertainment's manager Graham, who has lived in Spain for 13 years, has a go, without much success.
I haven't got a new book. It's 8 to 11-year-olds. So I can get by, but I forget things very quick. Here we go. Lolly. Tienes o manes?
Tienes.
Hermanos.
Three. Tres.
Tres?
Tres hermanos.
Tres, sí.
Bueno, right. Uno muerto, Dad.
Ah.
Ahora dos.
Happy days.
At Camping Villamar, the residents have adopted some Spanish traditions. Any excuse to get the paella pan out.
This is the sangria I made earlier.
Right, this is the bloke's fridge. It's full of liquid refreshments, of course.
And the secret of perfect paella?
Plenty of beer. Get all your guests, plenty of beer, and then they'll come along and they say, by the Christ, that's lovely, that. Keep the moisture in the chef and not none in the paella. Are we ready for this?
Can we have a round of applause, please, for Arthur?
Hairdresser boss Vicky Caton tries to bring a bit of Spain to her salon with a Spanish-themed day.
Today is going to be our Spanish day, so we're going to be giving everybody a little bit of tapa.
Some embrace the idea.
You don't just want egg and chips all the time. Yeah, of course you want to eat Spanish as well. I've already had an English breakfast this morning, so I'm doing both.
Others aren't so keen.
Just don't look very inviting, do
they? Come on, be brave.
But if you're terrified by tapas and petrified by paella, fear not. British tastes and traditions are well catered for in Benidorm, and for many expats, highlight of the week has to be the traditional Sunday roast.
You can't get away from the fact that we're British and we like Sunday dinner.
And Brits being Brits, it's all about the trimmings.
A few sprouts, carrots.
We have roast potatoes.
Mashed turkey.
Cabbage.
A couple of stuffing bowls.
Peas.
And if it doesn't have Yorkshire puddings, it is not a Sunday roast.
At Camping Benidorm, Dean's Sunday roasts are legendary, and for him, it's all about the gravy.
If you don't have good gravy, it's a bad meal. And the art of it is having thick gravy. If it's thin, it's no good. Nice and thick. Right, most of it's done there. Oh, they do pile it up high. They love it, don't they?
He's famous for his gravy.
They love the gravy, that's why they come in.
Dean has to graft for his gravy and knows from experience that the pub game can be punishing.
A lot of people think they can come over here, live the dream, open up a bar, but they don't realise it's all work.
So if you're dreaming of owning a bar here, beware. With around 2,000 clubs and bars, the competition is fierce, and running a boozer in Benidorm can be a one-way ticket to Stress Central.
What am I going to do?
Running a bar is seriously hard work, and Castlefield lad Tad knows more than most. He owns four of them.
We now call this place Taddy Dome.
Anyone thinking running a Spanish boozer is a recipe for lazy days in the sun, take heed. For Tad, it's a six-day week and 16-hour days with back-breaking shifts, but not much profit in the pocket.
You're never, ever going to be rich out here. And I've been working all my life.
But four bars isn't enough for our Tad, and he takes another punt on a rundown bar called the Queen Vic.
It's very old and tatty, but once I get my stamp on it, then it'll be a busy bar like the rest of them.
But be warned, doing up a bar can cost a pretty penny.
I reckon about €80,000, maybe €90,000. The bar's such a mess, it's got to be ripped out and got done.
What happens next is a valuable lesson for would-be bar owners in how Spanish bureaucracy can bite you on the bum. 4 weeks after Tad closes the Queen Vic for a refurb, the authorities force work on the site to stop.
Because we've had this put here, that's why they've closed us down. I must be losing maybe £2,000 a day. I've got to get this bar open.
And a few weeks later, the latest addition to his bar empire is still unfinished and it's costing him dearly.
I should be opening tonight. This will be grand opening. As you can see, we're nowhere near.
Tad's girlfriend Olivia is going to manage the bar and she's frustrated.
Nothing's going on. When I like getting to work and get what everybody else has got, which is if you can hear outside in the background, everyone's busy.
We haven't even got any power on. It's just maddening. That this is out at summer and we should be making loads of money now.
The Queen Vic does eventually open, but just as the high season draws to a close. It may have lost a fortune in takings, but Olivia's just relieved to be trading and looking forward to the future.
As you can see, there's been a big development and changes within the bar. Now we're just waiting for the kitchen to actually open, hopefully this week, and then it's all systems go then with the food. So it's all go.
Another punter moving into the pints game is ducker and diver Dave Dennis. Dave has a young family to support, so he turns his hand to anything to make a buck.
It may make me 10 euros, but 10 euros at the end of the day, that's food on the table.
But his up-and-down income is creating a huge strain.
Yeah, I don't know from one day to the next if I'm going to earn any money or not. It's getting to the point now where if I don't get something regular and secure that, you know, I've got to look at sort of going back to the UK, which is something I really don't want to do.
Dave's found a cheap bar on sale for 14,000 quid, but the truth is, you need one of two things to get into the Benidorm bar business: books in the bank or a backer. Dave's got little in the way of savings.
It's frustrating when you get the opportunities and you just haven't got any money to buy them.
So he's desperate for his mate Brian to lend him the money.
What are your initial thoughts? Reckon you want to go for it?
In the end, Dave doesn't need Brian's cash. He comes to an agreement with the current owner of the bar and sets to work refurbing the boozer.
There's so much that goes into a bar that you don't even realise. It's amazing how far the money doesn't go. I probably put 8 grand in this place in 6 weeks. And if you look around, you'll go, where? You know what I mean? Because you really can't see it.
In the blink of an eye, it's opening night.
Opening nights and all the rest of it, hit or miss, but it's always just that little bit where it gets started, you know what I mean? You have that butterflies in your stomach.
Happily for Dave, the punters pile in and pack out the bar.
Blown away. Couldn't have wanted more. Absolutely fantastic. If tonight's an indication of the future, then my son will be all right. So he'll get to continue living the dream in the sun.
Since then, Dave's had a great few first months with the bar, takings have trebled, and now he's considering turning it into a Mexican-themed bar and restaurant for the new summer season. Sombreros out, everyone. Benidorm is foot to the floor, full-throttle Costa Blanca craziness. So sometimes it's nice to hit the gas and head out of town. And our bargain-loving Brits have found clever ways of getting away from the Benidorm crowds without having to splash the cash. There are lots of hidden gems just a short hop from the high-rises. Expat Ben Rigby and his dad, Mick, are on a lad's fishing trip.
We're off on a road trip.
They head for Masquerat, 10 kilometres north of Benidorm.
So this is where we're going to be fishing, right here on the rocks here.
Yo. Let's get fishing.
A Benidorm breakfast. Kebab.
There's a pretty big fish in town already.
Is that Abramovich? Is that one? That's it. Money bags. Who owns Chelsea? That's his boat there.
That is one boat, that.
All to have money, eh?
But a Russian oligarch's bank account isn't necessary for this trip.
A lot of people do come out for excursions. It costs them quite a bit of money. It costs us nothing. Just a few cans from the supermarket and a bit of bait. And that's it.
The boys might have their bait, but it doesn't guarantee a bite.
That's why we're not catching any fish, it's your fault.
Oh, it's all these bloody jet skis and boats, isn't it? Excuse me, will you tell them people to stop enjoying themselves?
Another cheapest chips destination? The stunning Algar Waterfalls, just 15 kilometres inland. It's a favourite budget day out for lecturer Eric Edwards, who cruises there on his motorbike. Entrance fee? Just €4.
Between the parking, meal, petrol, and getting in here, €10. About £7.50 in English money. And it's a whole day.
If you don't have your own wheels, there are other ways to see the sights. So-called blanket trips are free coach trips to the countryside run by companies in return for a sales pitch.
One of you lucky people get to get in bed with me.
And they're a particular favourite of super savers, Barry and Barbara.
We've been on the blanket trips loads of times. If you want to see somewhere that's not in Benidorm, it doesn't cost you anything.
Barry's tip for keeping the trip cost-free?
It's like an auction. You keep your hands in your pocket. Don't wave them around, otherwise you'll end up spending money.
Right, well, thank you very much, Barry. I ask you to go back to those extremely comfortable chairs over there.
Got me very close to buying this time, but not quite.
No, it was that grip I had on your hand that stopped you, wasn't
yeah,
it?
No, yeah, yeah, somewhat like that.
Many bar owners also run coach tours to the countryside. Paul and Jackie have organised a winery trip for their regulars.
Please enjoy your trip. I'll see you when you all get back.
Oh, yeah, off wine tasting. Don't even like wine.
Like we'd be seen helping you down the bus.
Once inside the bodega, our thrifty Brits are in their element, bagging bargains of the alcoholic variety.
They're all 120 a litre, and you bring your own water bottle like that, and you fill it. 5 litres, and it's, you know, 10 euros.
Oh, yes, it's as cheap as water, but it tastes better. Cheers!
Welcome back to our guide to living a cut-price Costa Blanca lifestyle. When budgets are tight, it pays to watch the pennies. And here's a money-saving masterclass. Super scrimpers Catherine and Patricia are 60-year-old twins from Warrington. They bought a caravan together on Camping Villamar 12 months ago, and they've hardly spent a penny since. Here's how.
I have a diary, and I write how much I've spent. In this week, all I spent was €1. I think when people have been here for a while, they say, right, we're living here now, we really need to tidy our belts, you know.
Or tighten them. Their favourite activity is patrolling the shower block, and one spot in particular offers rich pickings.
Patricia and I call it Walmart, because you can go and you can pick up virtually anything for free. See, someone's put those on there, they're Walmart. Somebody doesn't want them, and they're not old. We got these from Walmart.
One person's trash is another person's treasure, and there's nothing like getting a buzz from something that you really want to treasure, and somebody's throwing it out because it's their trash. So it's great, isn't it?
Yes. Yes.
We love it.
Another pair of cash-conserving bin divers are Eddie and Pauline from Middlesbrough. Their unorthodox top tip: get a pitch by the bins.
So they're only, what, 20 foot away?
For many people, that would be a disaster. But for this resourceful pair, it's a gold mine.
It's surprising the stuff that does come. You get like these things here, people just throw stuff away. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. Yeah, come on, no problem.
This is just one of a long line of unwanted acquisitions for Eddie and Pauline.
That bank was over there. All I've done is adjusted the brakes. There's nothing wrong with it, really.
We got 14 beach towels out of there one day.
My favourite chair, this one was over there. So I've had to put someone on there because it goes so far back. When I get to sleep on this, like, you can hear me snoring.
For these two, their view of the bin means only one thing. They're
definitely living the dream.
Fulfilling their dream are Benidorm showman Wayne and his partner Des. They've flown back to Manchester, Wayne's hometown, to get hitched. But they're acting like a married couple already.
He had two jobs to do for the wedding: bring the English phone and the camera. He forgot the camera and he forgot the English phone.
Des's 17-year-old daughter, Jodie, has the best seat in the house.
If there is any person here who knows of any lawful impediment why these two people may not be joined together in marriage today, then you must declare it now.
I take you as my friend and lover, the father to Jodie, and my husband and the dogs. I promise to cherish and respect you, to care for and protect you, to comfort and encourage you, and to stay with you for all eternity.
Who wrote that shit?
Gives me the very greatest of pleasure to declare that you are now husband and husband.
Been a turbulent year, and the showboat's gone goodbye, but we're married. We've got a life, haven't we, which is the key thing now, isn't it?
Des and Wayne will soon be returning to the place they love.
Benidorm, after 20-odd years, I'm coming up to my 25th season. It's my life. Really looking forward to going back and celebrate with our friends there. It's happy days and here's to the future.
If our guide has given you the get up and go to bid adios to Britain and hola to Benidorm, then you should come prepared to do a lot of one thing in particular: laughing. Benidorm seems to give lots of expats a new lease of life.
Are you ready to rock?
How are you ready to hit the floor? Are you ready to shake your body?
Our philosophy, when you get to our age, yesterday's gone, tomorrow you don't know whether it's going to come, you live for today.
82-year-old Grace Campbell is an outrageous octogenarian with the most infectious laugh in Benidorm.
I love cooking with wine. Sometimes I put it in the food. That's me when I was young. Would you have fancied me?
And she credits the Benidorm sun for her sunny disposition.
When I used to draw the curtains in the morning, rain again. Next morning, rain again. I got fed up with that. You come here, you're not even awake and the sun's shining.
Grace benefits greatly from being here, without a doubt. It wouldn't be the same for her in the UK. You know, she'd wither away. She is the life and soul of any party.
Grace has a simple recipe for happiness in life.
Always laugh and love. Don't get down. Or if you do, snap out of it.
She's a diamond. There's nothing else to be said about her. She's a lovely, lovely old lady.
There's only one way to describe Grace. She is amazing Grace.
A fitting way to round off our budget-conscious guide to Benidorm, where expat life doesn't cost the earth and where dull moments are few and far between.
Whoa, whoa! Come on, get out.
I love Benidorm! Yay!
Knock them dead.
Hasta la vista.
Hasta la vista.
Finding more efficiency.
Smile in action.
Because it looks nothing like me in real life.
Smile.
I'm going all unnecessary.
That's it there, so the party's finished till next stop. Happy days.